This quick guide to the CAR T cell therapy journey, apheresis to infusion, will cover information about what is CAR T treatment, treatment process, and ways to support yourself for a better experience.
If you have had at least two types of treatment for certain types of leukemia or lymphoma, or at least four treatment types for multiple myeloma, CAR T cell therapy may be an option for you. Your past treatments may have included chemotherapy, radiation, and/or stem cell transplant. CAR T cell therapy, or CAR T, is a type of cancer treatment that helps ramp up your immune system to seek out and kill cancer cells.
Every patient treated will get CAR T cells created in the lab just for them. This video gives an overview of the treatment process. Watching it will help you learn what lies ahead. To learn more about CAR T cell therapy as a treatment option, watch our CAR T cell therapy quick guide.
Step 1. Your T cells, which are a type of white blood cell, are collected from your bloodstream in a procedure called apheresis. Apheresis is a process in which your blood is passed through a machine that separates out the T cells and then returns the rest of your blood back to you. This procedure may take a few hours.
To prepare for the apheresis, I had to drink a lot of fluids. So hydration is huge. What I didn't realize is that I was drinking a bunch of water and that water doesn't really hydrate you as well as you would think. So when I got there, I still had to drink coconut water and Gatorade to actually, so that the cells would hold the hydration. And that was some of the hesitation. That's why some of my apheresis took longer, because it just took them that long to find veins to be able to go, you know, to be able to perform it. But after that, then it went pretty quickly.
Step 2. Your collected T cells are sent to a lab. There, chimeric antigen receptors, or CARs, are inserted into them. This makes them CAR T cells. The CARs are like a cancer cell tracking device. They will help your T cells find and destroy cancer cells. Step 3. Your CAR T cells will stay in the lab so that they have time to grow and make millions more CAR T cells over a couple weeks. When there are enough, the lab will send the CAR T cells back to your treatment team or will freeze and store them for your future use.
Step 4. Your doctors will make sure your cancer stays under control while your CAR T cells are being made. If your cancer starts to grow, you may have treatment to get it back under control. This is called bridging therapy. Needing bridging therapy does not mean that you have failed or that CAR T won't work as well. It just means your cancer has to be put back under control before you can get started.
Step 5. You will be treated with conditioning chemotherapy. This might also be called lymphodepleting chemotherapy. Your CAR T doctor will decide which chemotherapies you will receive and how many days of it you'll need. This is done to make room in your immune system for the new CAR T cells. It is not the same as bridging chemotherapy.
Most people get conditioning chemotherapy from their CAR T team. Some get it from their primary cancer doctor. Each appointment will typically last for 4 to 6 hours, but the exact length may differ. Your doctor will let you know how long each appointment will take.
Prior to my infusion, which was on November 19th, 2014, I did have to have lymphodepleting chemo to prepare my body for the CAR T cell infusion. And that entailed a couple of chemos, and it was outpatient, very minor side effects, nothing compared to all the chemotherapies that I'd had previously, which were all inpatient. So for me, it was very minor chemotherapy.
Tell your healthcare team about every side effect, no matter how minor. The most common side effects from conditioning chemotherapy are fatigue or feeling tired, nausea, vomiting, constipation or diarrhea, lack of appetite or taste changes, headache, low blood counts, hair loss or thinning. Use your anti-nausea medication if you need it. Also, chemotherapy can cause your eyes to feel dry or to water. If you wear contacts, bring your glasses. You will then have one or more days of rest.
Your goal is to stay as healthy as you can during the days of chemotherapy and days of rest. You will want to drink 2 to 3 quarts or 8 to 12 cups of water a day. Your doctor may also ask you to come in to get fluids through a vein by IV. Eat a healthy diet. Be as active as you can. Take walks. Sit at a table for meals. Chat with friends and family. If you are feeling dizzy, weak, or confused, walk with a caregiver. Stay away from people who are sick. Wash your hands often throughout the day. Always wash hands before eating and after using the bathroom. Wash with soap as long as it takes to sing the Happy Birthday song twice. Avoid injury. Don't do anything that may cause you to get hurt or bleed. Try to avoid getting constipated, blowing your nose, or walking barefoot. Use an electric shaver to prevent cuts. Use lip balm to keep your lips moist and fragrance-free moisturizers to keep your skin from getting dry. Use a soft toothbrush. Do not use over-the-counter medications, herbs, or supplements without getting approval from your CAR-T team. Use sunscreen rated at least SPF 45 when outside. Remember to put it on your head, back of neck, and ears. Tell your CAR-T team right away if you feel like you are getting sick or have an infection, or if you have a fever of 100.4 degrees Fahrenheit or more. They may need to delay your CAR-T infusion until you are feeling better. Let your CAR-T team know if you are anxious or have any concerns about the treatment.
What I tried to do to remain healthy during between apheresis and infusion was make sure I hydrated, try to walk as much as I can, knowing that thereafter would be some time where I wouldn't be as, you know, mobile. So I did that, spent a lot of time with the boys and my husband and the family, making sure that the, you know, they made sure that groceries were done and that whatever mom wanted when she got home was going to be set. And so that's what I did to prepare.
Step 6, the infusion. Your healthcare team will tell you if your treatment will be given either as inpatient or outpatient. Your CAR-T cells are put into your body through a central venous catheter, which may be located in your arm or neck. The infusion will take about 30 minutes while your vitals are checked. Be sure to wear comfortable clothes to your infusion appointment. A loose-fitting or button-down shirt is best.
If your treatment is given as an inpatient, expect to check into the hospital and stay there for at least 8 days. It could be longer if you develop side effects. After you check out, you will still need to be close to the hospital, 30 to 60 minutes away or less, until at least 4 weeks after infusion. This could be your home, a hotel, or another type of housing arrangement. If you develop side effects, you may need to check back into the hospital. Or you may get CAR-T as an outpatient. This means you can leave the clinic or hospital after the infusion, but you must stay close to the hospital, 30 to 60 minutes away or less, for at least 4 weeks after the infusion. This could be your home, or it could be a hotel or apartment or other housing option. Outpatients need to tell their treatment team if they develop any side effects and may need to check into the hospital if they do. When you are staying near the CAR-T center, you must go to their hospital. Do not go to an emergency room at a different hospital, even if it is closer. They may not know how to treat CAR-T cell therapy side effects. Follow your CAR-T team's instructions if they tell you to come to the hospital. They may ask you to avoid the emergency room and come directly to a floor instead.
Your caregiver will need to be with you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, all day, every day, for at least 4 weeks after you get your CAR-T infusion. You and your caregiver will need to stay near the CAR-T Cancer Center and hospital during this time. Their job is to monitor how you are feeling and alert your care team if you're having any side effects. After 4 weeks, you and your caregiver no longer need to stay within 30 to 60 minutes of the CAR-T center. However, your caregiver still needs to stay with you for another 4 weeks. Some side effects can occur up to 8 weeks after your infusion. After 8 weeks, your CAR-T team will usually let you start driving again. You can learn more about this step in your treatment in our e-learning video about CAR T side effects. To learn more about CAR T cell therapy or to request materials, please visit our website at www.cancersupportcommunity.org/CAR T.
Needing ongoing and repeated treatments and/or changes to your body caused by treatment can cause anxiety, sadness, depression, or frustration. Know that you are not alone. Support is available. It can include individual counseling, cancer and immunotherapy support groups, one-to-one mentoring, online or in person, mylifeline.org. Exercise your mind and body through mindfulness, meditation, or yoga. Talk one-on-one with an oncology social worker, therapist, or spiritual advisor. Call the Cancer Support CAR T Helpline at 844-792-6517.
This is the end of our CAR T Cell Therapy Journey Quick Guide. To learn about side effects you may experience and how to cope, see our quick guide to CAR T cell therapy side effects.